Hi guys, and welcome to another Elementor Builder video. This is Jamie from System22 and WebDesignAndTechTips.com. Well, we've got a nice little hover effect here today. We've got an image. When you hover over it, it's got a drop down call to action with a little action button right there. Let go and it pops back up. Nice little feature to have on your site. We've recently done this with the Divi theme and somebody requested that we did it for Elementor, so here you go. Really easy to do. We've got to do a bit of coding for this today, but the CSS code that I write, I'll put down below and you're welcome to use it any way you wish. So I've got this page open with Elementor. I've got a section with three columns in it. Let's work on this column over here, number three. First thing I'm going to do is put a text module in there. I'm presuming you're using the free version of Elementor today. So I'm going to use a text editor module. Simply left click, drag it, drop it in there. I'm going to add a little title. Now I'm going to make that a heading 3 probably. There we go. And down below here, we want a little link to act as our call to action button. So whatever it is you want it to say. And let's link it to somewhere. Select it, hit the link, little link icon up here. And best practice is if you're putting it in your own site, just hit the apply. Got to put a link in there. I'm just going to put a hashtag. And if you're linking it to elsewhere, hit the little cog and select open in a new tab. I'll just show you that. Open link in a new tab. If you're linking off your site, that will keep your site open. That's always best practice. Let's make sure we've got our link in there. Okay, so there's our little link down there. Can't see it there because my link's set to be white on this site, but you can make it whatever color you want when we do a bit of styling in a minute. Next thing I want to do is put all this in the middle, so I'm going to select it all and just center align it right there. Okay. Now next thing I want to do is put the actual image in that we want to see initially. And that's actually residing in the column here, dark tab for the column, little blue tab for the actual text module we're using. So let's go into the column and we'll go over to style. Background type, I'm going to hit the little paintbrush and just add whatever image it is you want to use there. I'll use that same one. Okay, it looks like it's just showing the top corner of it right there. So position wise, you can position it where you want, but firstly I'm going to make the size to cover so it covers the whole area. There we go, and that's going to work absolutely fine. Don't want it to repeat. Sometimes if you want to reposition, you can reposition it top, bottom, wherever is the action or whatever it is you want to see most of in there. As you can see, we can see our little call to action title right here now. Okay, well I want to make that into more of a button. So if we go back into the text module here, I'm going to flip over to the little text tab up here. And as we can see, it's already got some nice little style tag right there, text center. So I can add style after the semicolon there. I'm going to give it a black background. So I'm going to say background black, which hex code is hashtag 000. As you can see, that's got a black background now, but I don't really want it stretching the whole width. If you do, just leave it just exactly like that. I'm going to have mine, give it a fixed width. I'm going to say width 150 pixels, whatever you want, whatever's going to fit whatever you've got in there for your text. As you can see, that's made it 150 long, but we want it in the middle. So I'm going to add after the pixels there, semicolon. And again, I'll put the CSS down below. You can copy and paste it if you need to. I'm going to make it central by saying margin auto. There we go, that's popped it in the middle. I want that button a bit fatter, so I'm going to give it a bit of padding too. So I'm going to say semicolon and padding. If I just give it one value, it'll give it all round, and it won't do the width because we've got that width attribute in there. So I'm going to do 15 pics. There we go, that looks more like a button to me. Great, so we've got our button, we've got our text here. I want to turn that text white. We can do that in our styling, actually, our styling tab right here. There we go. And I want to give it a bit of padding all round. So at the moment it stops there. The reason it's coming down to here is because that's what we've got over here and the columns are adjusting for that height. So I'm going to go over to my advanced and I'm going to give it 30 pixels padding all around. There we go. Now if we've got the chain linked, it'll do all at once. If you want to do separately, just uncheck the chain and you can do top, bottom, left and right separately. But I'm happy with that. Okay, now we've got to make the actual magic happen, which is we've got to make this disappear and then reappear when we hover over it, and we're going to have it coming down from the top. So this is where the custom CSS comes in. So I'm going to work on the actual module itself, the text module or the text editor module. Now with Pro, you can write the custom CSS in here. With the free version, you have to do it in the theme customizer. So if I go over here and we go to the desktop or dashboard, I should say, down to appearance, customize. This is where you'd put your additional CSS in here. Just create a space for it, put it at the top, put it wherever you like. Good idea to give it a title. But for convenience, so we can do it all on the page to save me switching pages here, I'm going to write mine in the customizer here. But like I say, if you're using the free version, whatever CSS you've got, just plonk it in here. It'll do exactly the same thing for you. Okay, to make this happen, in our text editor, I'm going to go over to advanced. We've got to give it a CSS class. CSS class is down here. Call it something that makes sense to you. I'm going to call it CTA drop, or call to action drop down. I'm going to copy that in my custom CSS. I'm going to put it there. Now it's a class name, so you have to have a period or a dot in front of it, like that. And if we were going into the customizer, I'll just plop it over there for you. Exactly the same thing. Take that away right now. Okay. Then we need to open and close some curly brackets. What do we want it to do? Well, we want it to be up here somewhere until we hover over it. So we're going to say margin, top, negative 400. That's what I used on the other one, so it should work fine here. As you can see, it's disappeared, and you can just see the bottom of the button poking down up there. And when we hover over it, I want it to come back down again. So I'm going to copy this, Control C, drop down. Just after the P of CTA drop there, I'm going to put no space, colon, then no space again and the word hover. And I'm going to say margin 0. So we want it to be back down when we hover on it. If I hover on it. But nothing happens when we hover over it. It's because it's not there to hover on. It's actually up here. So what we need to do is put a bit of padding on the bottom so it knows to come down, because it'll come down when I hover over it up there, but not when we're actually hovering over the image, which is what we want. So what we can do here, try padding bottom, 400 pixels. That'll give it padding on the bottom of 400. Now it's working, but we've got an extra 400 when we're hovering over it. So we need to say, on the hover, simply do the same thing. Now it'll drop down and we haven't got all that space on the bottom there, which is great. So it's doing pretty much what we want. It's a bit quick for me, so I'm going to slow mine down for a bit of drama here. And we do that in the actual regular state, not the hover state. So I'm going to say transition dash duration. And I'm going to make mine about 3/4 of a second, but that's entirely up to you. So 0.75 seconds. That should be a lot more gradual now. Okay, well, that's pretty good. But some of this text could be a bit sharper on the background. What I've done with this one, I've added a little background color, an opaque background color when we hover over it, so you can read that text a little easier. It's not too bad on this image, but some images, especially if they're busy, it'll get lost in there. We can do this up here at the background. Just hit the little chevron. You've got a normal state. I'm going to leave that just as it is. But when we hover over it, I'm going to add a background color. So I'm going to hit the little cube there. Find a color. It doesn't matter what color you use. I used the blue last time. And whatever blue you want there. And it'll only show up when we're hovering over it. But I want to see some of the image behind there. So I'm going to bring the opacity down, probably about 40-50%. Whatever works for the image and text that you've got on there. I think you can read that pretty well and see the button and everything. Now there's one last thing that we need to do. If you notice up at the top there, when this is sliding in, you can see it sliding in from the top there because it's sort of coming in from the top. And I want to hide that. So what we need to do is go into our column again, which is the little dark tab, edit column. We'll go down to the custom CSS in the advanced tab, custom CSS. And we'll give it, we've got to give it a name. We've got to give it a class to be able to do this. So we'll, in the advanced tab, we'll give it a class. I'll call it column C, CTA drop. So column CTA drop down. Copy that class. We'll go to our custom CSS. I'll put it in here. It's class name, so it must have a period in front of it again. I'm going to open and close some curly brackets again. Inside, we're just going to put one little line of code. We're going to say overflow colon hidden. And as you can see, it's disappeared there now, but when we hover over, it's just coming in, and that's stopping anything that's outside this column here from being visible. It's hiding the overflow. So we should be good to go. So let's publish. And we'll have a look. You need to hit the have a look or hit the little eyeball there. It'll do the same thing. And here we are. There's our little image. When I hover over, we've got our little call to action there. Like I say, that's a nice little effect to have on your site. Really easy to do. And I'll put all this CSS code down below. Like I say, if you're using the free version, just pop it in your additional CSS in the customizer here. It'll do exactly the same thing for you. So there you go, guys. I hope you've enjoyed this today and found it useful. If you have, please give it a thumbs up, ring the bell, comment, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and WebDesignAndTechTips.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.